over my bag, and then some gladiolus, look, my peas, snow pea or sugar snap pea, whatever you call it, is very tall. It's like 5'5" now. Okay, and after that is the kale, celtus, and there's more celtus. There's a garlic chive. There's a chive. And then here is the more lettuce stuff. And scallion goes to flower. I want to harvest the flower. This is my blueberry. Look how many blueberries on it. Okay, this is my raised bed for raspberry and garlic chives. And some gladiolus in the back. Another blueberry and dill and tomato and fig tree. I have two fig trees this year. This is a centrok. Yes, centrok. Okay. And then look at like that little flower. And here is another blueberry and thyme. Look how beautiful the thyme is. And then the blueberry. Start to harvest from this tree. And this is the garlic. Nice. Going to harvest in late June. And a kohlrabi, several kohlrabi. And this is zucchini, tomato, garlic, some tongkol, some more tomato, garlic. And there's a sweet potato and the Thai basil, some pepper, teeny tiny pepper, rosemary, peony flower, and thyme. I harvest a lot of thyme now. This is, I know the Chinese name is called Mei Ren Jiao. Beautiful. And carrot. And cucumber, look how many cucumber. And another zucchini, more Mei Ren Jiao. And here's the, look how big the garlic. I harvest two of them. This lot, we have some tomato, a type of beans. More beans, corn. Look, this field of corn, it's nice. Beans alongside. And more garlic. Okay, gladiolus in the end. Here, more gladiolus in another bed. Lettuce, Swiss chard. And this is tomato. Tomato in between, another round of beans. Here, more beans, loofah. This is loofah for the sponge purpose. Here are the zucchini. My husband used his method to trim it down and to avoid bug infection. And in the end, there are another type of a zucchini. It's a flower-shaped zucchini. Yes, thank you.